Hello everyone, welcome back to the course Application Development using Python. In the previous sessions we have discussed about elements of flow control, that is if, else if, elif and else statements, and how to use it. And we have written a simple program and we have checked how it works. Okay, in this session we will be discussing about the loop. Okay, that is specially we are discussing about the while loop, continue and break statements, how to use it in Python. Let us begin our session with simple program. So while loop, whenever that statements in front of while loop, if it is true, that block of code which comes under that while loop will keep on executing until that while statement is false. Once that while statement is false, then loop will come out of that, or control will come out of that loop. So let me write the keyword while is very important here, and after that conditions we have to check is that true or not, and after that we have to check about the colon. And after that, whatever statement we want to execute continuously, that must be inside the block. So block, you we all know that will start with the indentations. Okay, let me start with the simple program. To write that program, I need an editor. Okay, so editor I will save first. I have saved this file with the .py extension. Okay, loop.py. So spam is equal to zero. I'm initializing spam with zero. Before that, I will go with the simple if statement. Spam less than 5. What I will do is I will print hello Sahadri. And also what I will do is, after printing hello spam is equal to spam plus 1. Okay, spam plus 1. Let me check this code. Obviously what will happen is it will print just hello world only once. So if we want to print this hello world multiple times, for example, if we want to print hello world 5 times, then so simple changes I have to make here, that is, instead of if I have to use while. Okay, so let us check that if I change that loop if statement, you can observe here it is printing hello Sahadri. You can observe here it is printing hello Sayali 5 times. Let us go with the program. Initial line spam is initialized to 0. So when it is initialized to 0, it is obviously of type integer. Then while is the keyword and spam is the variable. It is 0 right now. If it is less than 5, it is true. So the compiler will print hello Sayadri, and after that it will increment that spam by 1. So now spam, earlier it was 0, now it become 1. Okay, so earlier spam was 0, after this statement spam is equal to 1 in the first iterations. And next, in the while loop, spam is less than 5. Right now spam is 1, so it is true, the condition is true, then it will execute the hello world once again. So until that statement is true, once it is spam become 5, it will come out of that loop. This is the basics of while loop. Okay, sometimes some loop will not end. Okay, so we call it as annoying while loop. Okay, we'll go with the simple example of this type of loop. Okay, so in the previous sessions, what discussions or what simple example we have taken for writing the name, same way we will go with the writing the name with the, inside the while loop until it is correct. Okay, until that name is correct one, it system should keep on asking the name. Okay, so once that correct name user will enter, so then it will come out of that loop. That type of program we will write now. Okay, name, initially I will not initialize with the name is a string only. Okay, name is string. Now I will check while name not equal to Sahyadri. Okay, until name not equal to Sahyadri, I'll ask that one, please type your name. A system should ask, please type your name. There is a small mistake I have done, that is P with second. Okay, the print, it will ask name. Now I will again update with name. Initially it was just a string, empty string. Now I'm taking from the keyboard. Okay, so this statement will keep on execute these two, please type your name, please type your name, please type your name, how many times, until this name is equal to Sahyadri. Until this name is equal to Sahyadri means name not equal to Sahyadri, that means true. Other than Sahyadri, whatever you write, that means while statement will be true. It will keep on asking the name. Okay, once it is true, then it will come out of that loop. Then we will tell hello Sahyadri, congratulations. Let us check this program. Please type your name. Again, I will write something GH. Please type your name again HG. Please type your name RT. Please type your name YU. Okay, so once again I will type some other things. Just keep on asking me. Okay, it is not coming out of the loop. Okay, so if I want to come out of that loop, I have to write the correct name. So hello Sahyadri, congratulations. So until I write this correct one, it will keep on asking that. So that's why we say it sometimes hello Sahyadri. It's the same program we can write, same program we can write with the some other with the help of break statements. Okay, that is one of the main topic we were going to discuss in this sessions, that is break statement. We'll let us see that how we can alter this program with the break statement. So whatever I have written earlier, that I will make it as a comment. Why true? Okay, this is an unlimited loop. So until that you break that loop, it will not come out of that. So it will ask print, please type your name. While true, print, please type your name. Name is equal to input. I'm taking it from the keyboard. If name is equal to Sahyadri, Now what I will do is I will break from the loop. I will come out of that loop, particularly from while loop. Then I will say print thank you. Okay, so here you can observe with the help of break statement. Earlier I was trying in the loop conditions only, checking that is the name is Sayadri, then it will stop that loop. Instead of that, what I will do is here I have written loop statement with infinite loop, and I will come out of that loop whenever that name or input is Sayadri. So it is keep on asking anything, it will keep on asking. Let me write Sahadri. Thank you. So this is our break statement. So whenever you want to come out of any loop, you can use this break statement. So this break statement can be followed by some conditions. Okay, when some conditions are true, you can go with the break statement. Okay, next, continue statement. So sometimes whenever you want to go back to the conditional statements or loop checking, okay, so then we can use with the continue statement. Some situations will come like where instead of in a block, in a loop block, there are 10 lines of codes are there. If you consider in a loop, okay, so that loop is true, it must execute 10 lines of code. But instead of executing all the 10 lines of code, you can again check that conditions in the fifth statement only. In the fifth statement only, that is with the help of continue. After fifth statement, you can just keep continue. So you can use the keyword continue, then it will go back to the while loop conditions, and it will check that conditions again. So let us discuss this point with the help of one example. Let me clear all the content here. Now while true. While true, okay, print in another way some statements in print statement I have changed, print who are you, print who are you, name is equal to input name not equal to Joe. If name not equal to Joe, then okay, if name is equal to Joe, what happens? If name not equal to Joe, if name is not equal to Joe, again it should ask the name. Here my intention is it is like a login page for some blog or some websites or some applications. Okay, so in that case, first it should ask the name. If it is name is only not equal to that expected name, then it should ask the name again. If it is that name is true, then it should ask for password. For that reason, I can use continue here. Continue means it will again go with the loop initialization. So it will ask the name again. Continue. Okay. So otherwise what happens? It will go with the statement like hello Joe. Enter your password. Next, again, I will check that if password is equal to fish. If password is equal to fish, then I can break this loop, right? Name also correct and password also correct. Otherwise, and also I can say that access is granted. Otherwise, it will keep on asking the name and it will keep on asking the password. Okay, first if name is true, then it will keep on asking password. If password is also correct, then it will say access granted. Otherwise, it will say enter your password again. Okay. Let us check this code. Okay, who is you? Or sorry, I was supposed to write who are you. Let me correct this. Access granted. Let me correct this small mistake. Who are you? Joe, small letter I use, it is not giving me access. HAFGGHHK. So it will keep on asking when I'm writing correctly. Password, if I write something, again it is asking me name because it is a wrong person. Joe, and again asking me password fish when I enter, so it is giving me access granted. This is how you can use two things, that is break and continue. Okay, so in this sessions we have discussed about while loop and how to use break and how to use continue. In the next sessions we'll be discussing about for loop and range functions. Happy learning. Thank you.